looking to avenge a loss just recently against this Greenville team. The men are looking to avenge their women counterparts against Greenville University as they look to get their season started, or rather, get their 2023 side of the season restarted. And they try to pick up a win here in Eureka, the home conference opener. I'm Spencer Davis, joined by Joshua Howard. Josh, this is going to be a wild game, to say the least.
Yeah, it's going to be a wild game. You know, like you said, revenge on their mind for more reason than one. This Red Devil team definitely coming out, trying to execute, trying to get back on the right track. They had a game against Maryville in their last one. It was tightly contested in the first half, and then kind of got away from them there in the second half. So, you know, those just screws they got to tighten up, things they got to fix. But, you know, this team is definitely motivated to get back on track, and they want to start 2023 right, winning here on their home floor.
Yeah, SLIAC conference opener as well, so a big opportunity to kind of put their stamp on this conference run that they'll hopefully go on. Austin Ellison, speaking of that game against Maryville, got his kind of scoring touch back, 17 points for him, led the team in scoring. Cody Bear, four straight games with a double-double now. He's been on a heck of a run.
Extremely impressive. Cody Bear has been killing it. He's been a monster, as we've seen. He's been SLIAC Player of the Week already once this year, so, you know, he's just got to keep up the great work. Four players in double figures in that Maryville game, so, you know, if they can find a way to continue to replicate that, and they just got to find a way to tighten up that defense, this team can be very good, and they can pick up a win here tonight to start 2023.
And this team, they're coming up against the Greenville Panthers. They're 1-10, but don't let that deceive you. They're averaging 106.5 points per game. Granted, they're giving up about 130 per game. The best way I can describe what's about to take place is it's a term called total football. 1970s, the Netherlands would run dudes just at whoever had the ball, and that's what it's going to look like. It's just everyone attack the basketball, and if you can get out of this trap defense, you're going to put up a lot of points.
Yeah, and the Red Devils, they just got to make sure they make the correct decisions. You don't want to let this team turn you over. They only had 9 turnovers in their last game out against Maryville, so, you know, keeping up that low turnovers will be smart and help them in this. And then, you know, they got out-rebounded by 9 in that last game, so you want to fix that rebounding, win the rebounding tilt if you can here tonight. And, you know, as long as you take care of those details, they should definitely come away with one tonight.
Guys to look out for on Greenville's side, Keyshawn Thomas is their leading scorer. He comes off of the bench, so somebody you really have to watch out for in terms of a spark plug.
Yeah, sounds like a little bit of Lou Williams on their side, so you got to be paying attention for him. It's weird when it sounds like a lot of times the best player, maybe you should say, coming off the bench, but they got to know that, you know, when the starters go out, that it's not mean they're going to be relieved of having to play hard, having to make sure they're on their toes and dotting their I's and crossing their T's. So they got to make sure that they play a full 40 and that they play with respect to everyone on this Greenville team. You don't want someone going off causing you to lose.
Josh, keys to the game. What do we have to do to bring home a W?
So, you know, once more, winning that rebound battle, losing in the last game 45-36, you want to win that. You don't want to give up 40 rebounds to a team if you can avoid it, and obviously you want to limit them to as many one-shot opportunities down the court as you can. Keeping the turnovers low is always going to be smart, and then executing well in that trap that you talked about to get those easy shots.
That's all we have for you on the pregame show. On the other side, we've got starting lineups and first half action. You're watching Eureka College Basketball on ECTV.
At the top of your game, you're unstoppable. Nothing can throw you off track. Wait, is that your car? Uh-oh. Yeah, I saw that coming. That will throw you off track. You're looking at around 10 grand in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Let's try this again. Smart move. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
It's on us. It's on all of us. And it's time to act now.
It's on us to start the change. It's on us to be the change. It's on us. It's on Division III. It's on all of us to stop sexual assault.
One in three adults has
announcer who has the starting lineups for us
between the Greenville Panthers and your Eureka Red Devils. Both Eureka College and the NCAA promote good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds removal from the facility. Thank you for your cooperation. Now let's meet tonight's starting lineups, first for the visiting Greenville Panthers. Five-foot-11 junior from Augusta, Arkansas, number 11, Trenton Lee. A 6-foot sophomore from Flemington, California, number 22, Adrian Alvarez. A 5-foot-11 senior from Muscatine, Illinois, number 24, Jared Johnson. A 6-foot-5 junior from Camarillo, California, number 33, Brock Bailey. And a 6-foot-8 junior from Denver, Colorado, number 40, Gawar Tuam. The Panthers are coached by head coach Dr. George Barber and assisted by Josh Crutchfield, Darian Burns, and Paul Merrifield, and managed. Now let's meet the starting lineup for your Eureka Red Devils. A 6th senior from Illinois, number 3, Austin Ellison. A 6-foot junior from Peoria, Illinois, number 5, Persich. A 6'10" forward from Peoria, Illinois, number 24, Cody Baker. And a 6'4" junior from Elmwood, Illinois, number 30, Charlie McKinnon. And a 6-foot senior from Hamilton, Illinois, number 34, Logan Dorothy.
So we've got our starting lineups. Joshua, don't get too comfortable with the guys out there for Greenville. They're going to bring on 5 really quick.
Yeah, you know, you told me the way they play, and I'm definitely happy I get to see it up close, although hopefully it's not too much of a problem for this Red Devil men's team.
We will find out. Should be a barn burner. Expect a lot of points. Cody Bear preparing to tip off. Gawar Tuam on the other side for Greenville. As we'll get this Slyak slate started.
I feel like that's a tongue twister in a way.
Definitely felt like it. Here's Dorothy reeling in the tip. And it'll be Ellison over to McKinty. Persich now, and Bear. Ellison with it. Dorothy knocked out of his hands, out of bounds, off of his knee.
Seemed like a lot of arm there. You know,
wrong.
Knee
no.
Must be the new word for arm, though. 2023 is changing things.
Here is Lee. Over to the side with Johnson. Pitch back. Devils sitting in their 2-3 zone. Lee with it once again, knocked out of his hands. Here's Ellison now on the break. Right side, through the contestant in.
We're the ones causing the chaos despite all their efforts. So far, it's good to see the Red Devils defense starting well.
Quick shot and in. That's Brock Bailey. This is Bear able to break the press. Able to escape the trap. Here's Persich now. Mid-range J up. No good. Rebounded by Tuam. McKinty fighting for it.
And Mike Tuam bothering that jump shot there by Persich. Well enough to get the miss.
Deep three up. Johnson, no good. Rebounded by Bear. Immediately triple teamed. Here's Persich now.
I see what you're talking about. And I can see how this could be, you know, a slightly dangerous team if they were all to get hot the way they play. It would be very annoying to deal with.
Dorothy now. His first points of the night. Johnson trying to get it to Tuam, able to do so. Mid-range jump shot, no good. Bear with another rebound. He triple-teamed once again. McKinty up the sideline with Persich.
Definitely one of the more unconventional play styles. Red Devils don't seem to be rattled much at all, though.
Here's McKinty now, able to do a little run or a little kiss off the glass.
And like you said, five subs already at the table.
They've been there for a while. I think
they have.
Went in there at 18:30. The nightmare is just beginning. Bailey through contact, no good. McKinty rebounds. Be Persich. Ellison with it. Going to drive the basket and fouled. Two free throws on the way for Eureka. Six to our score. They're making everyone wait for the second free throw.
I wonder how their coach thought up of this play style. It's just like, yeah, this is gonna work. I don't know if, you know, I'm not saying it's impossible to work, but I wonder how he thought it up.
Just sitting there, he's like, okay, what if we just had everybody guard the basketball? Trying to get all the numbers coming in to get names. Keyshawn Thomas amongst them. Donato Pukak. Jamie Calmes. Grady Smitley and Travis Dickey onto the court. Eureka pulling all of their rebounders, something you don't usually see in the first half, but when you're trying to make sure that this transition offense doesn't get set up behind you.
Yeah, it makes sense. Nearly a steal right there by Ellison.
Into the corner, Pukak now, three-pointer up from him, knocks it in, the LC transfer. We've seen Dang Pukak make some shots in our time. Ellison now, Euro step, lots of separation, can't finish. Dorothy fighting for a rebound, has it. And then he's trapped. Still has his dribble underneath the basket through contact, still fighting for it. Got it through more contact, basket is good, 9-5 our score.
Never giving up on it, great effort right there from Dorothy.
All the way to the corner, Dickey from three, no good. Ball loose, out of bounds off of Greenville. Be Cody Bear to inbound. Dorothy, now to Persich, quick break. He's going to find McKinty cutting to the basket. Nice finish. 11-5 now, 16-40.
Looks like the Red Devils have adjusted well so far to this unique play style that they're up against.
Kick back out, three-pointer up. Smitley, no good. Pukak trying to get an offensive rebound and is fouled. That is Joseph Craig out there, number 12. Apologies, not Jamie Calmes.
I can completely understand. My mind would be jumbled, too, if the lineup just changed completely every 2 minutes.
Pukak in the corner, able to find Dickey. Three-pointer up from him, knocked in. Tough three-pointer to knock in.
It's like almost like Kyle Korver-type moving three on that one.
Persich now able to find McKinty. McKinty fouled by Thomas. I've gotten my notes, bring your running shoes, and it definitely seems like we've done so far.
Definitely have done so early on in this one. Only 4 minutes have gone by. It seems like it's been longer just because of how much they're running.
It's a lot of possessions going to be had tonight. McKinty with it, harassed by Dickey, able to get by him, and off of his foot.
Seemed like he couldn't make the decision to pass or to keep dribbling.
Going to be Brown on for Ellison, his first minutes. So former teammates in Pee Wee Brown and Donato Pukak on the court at the same time.
Truly is a small world.
Smitley with it. Now Thomas trying to get it into Craig. Thomas trying to get some separation. Looked like a double dribble.
Definitely did. Couldn't help but raise my eyebrow like Dwayne Johnson on that one.
Mid-range jump shot from Smitley. Good. McKinty to Bear. He's trapped. Full court pass. Thomas picks it off.
Red Devils got to be careful. That style has kind of been able to stop them these last few possessions, get them five straight points, this Greenville team.
Thomas and Bear going after it. Mass substitution back in. And the new group comes in.
This is amazing.
Muhammad Dia, Jacob Lee, Jordan Boyd. Jamie Calmes now onto the floor. And Caden Johnson also. Bear with us.
You know, Coach making full use of the 15-man roster. No one will be without PT, so, you know, no parents to argue with after the games.
Offensive rebound now. Jump shot. No good. Ball loose. And out of bounds. It'll go to Eureka. Andrew Gonzalez onto the court for Eureka as well.
I feel like there's been 1,000 inbounds also. This, the turnovers or fouls from the way this game is being played. It's honestly an extremely unique experience, and I'm happy I'm here.
Gonzalez with it, able to find Cutting Ellison, couldn't quite bring it in. Body sprawling, and Brown takes a shoulder to the face.
You can tell, too, this team is very aggressive.
Yeah.
I believe that's the third foul that's been, you know, not just in general, but been received from like running into somebody.
Very active play style, to say the least. .14:56 remaining in this first half. Ellison now cutting to the basket. Little floater is good. Nice finish.
Avoiding the charge on that one smartly, too, as we saw set up in the lane.
Errant pass. Ellison couldn't quite bring it in. This is Boyd with it. Now with Dia. Brown with it now for Eureka. Nice move to get some separation all the way up the court. Euro step off the glass. No good. Boyd with it.
There's so many bodies around you when you drive. A lot of times you don't have a clear way that you can go. And I mean, it's leading two misses around the rim. Thankfully for them. Great jump ball there.
Great recovery there from Brown.
Yeah, you got to have great hands to pull a jump ball like wall in midair going by the offensive player and not get a foul there.
Starters back in for Greenville. Ben Carter onto the floor for Persich.
So I wonder if there's a method to his madness, because this time that sub was only like a minute and 6 seconds.
Yeah, we should track that.
See it's if like, there's like something special about it.
It's like watching hockey. Like you're seeing these line shifts come in every, you know, 2 minutes or so, and could not keep it in bounds. Trenton Lee. 13-10 hour score. 14-17. I feel like I've run a marathon already.
Thankfully, the Red Devils did not have to apply a lot of defensive pressure to get that turnover.
Gonzalez inbounding to Brown.
That has to be the cleanest bring the ball up that he's had. Any Eureka guard has had so far.
Ellison with Carter. Carter able to get by his man momentarily. Trapped now at the elbow. Loses the handle. Gonzalez with it. Ellison, Brown. Able to get a shot over to him. No good. Rebounded by Lee. Greenville quickly out in transition. Alvarez now from three. No good. Dorothy rebounds. And then fouled.
It's weird because every once in a while I can kind of see how the chaos is actually supposed to, like, get stops. Like,
yeah.
I can see it. Now that I'm seeing the vision, I'm hoping the vision doesn't, you know, blind us tonight and work.
They're actually pulling off that kind of trapping press there.
Yeah, because the moment you get a rebound, there's like four people there, and you don't know where to turn the pass because there's hands in every direction.
Dorothy with it. Nice cut from Gonzalez. Can't finish. Great find, though, from Dorothy. You'd like to see that play again. Alvarez now working around the perimeter. All the way to the basket. Johnson with a nice lefty finish.
Yeah, that was a nice finish there by Johnson. A tough one against the big fella.
Carter with it. Gonzalez. 13-12 our score. Here's Dorothy with it. Cross court. Carter able to find Brown underneath. Brown couldn't quite find Dorothy. A little too much smoke on that one.
And, you know, it worked on that possession. It's trying to speed you up. That pass just a little too fast right there. And now Greenville here with a chance to take, I believe, what would be their first lead of the game. Although I will say I am happy to see that the Red Devils have kind of dragged them into a more defensive game. The pace, the way this pace is going, they shouldn't reach 25 points for once, but who knows? I mean, not 25, 100.
That was a nice finish there. Yeah, Eureka's defense, like you just mentioned, they're really doing a good job of slowing down this Greenville attack.
Yeah.
And that's kind of the purpose of running a zone. Good finish by Craig there. Brown trapped in the corner and jump ball.
That was a close one. The Red Devils are going to keep it. I thought that a travel was going to be called there briefly. Thankfully, that was not the case. They got to find a way to get this ball up a little more comfortably because it seems like Greenville's play style is starting to affect them a little bit more here on these inbounds and attempts to get the ball up the court, like right there.
Tip pass. Carter able to keep it, though. McKinty just waits for a second.
The Red Devils continue to stretch their lead back out to three, not giving Greenville a chance to take the lead here.
Thomas has been quiet so far tonight. No points yet. Picked off Gonzalez. Quickly back out on the break. The Red Devils are. Brown, a little Euro step. Contact. Wanted a foul, but got the points.
I can definitely see where he's coming from, too. A lot of body contact right there, but he was able to get the tough finish through it.
Dickey now off of the hands of off of Dickey.
Coach saw two consecutive turnovers. He decided it's time to bring the next five. The Red Devils now with a chance to crack the 20-point mark and push their lead to the most it's been all night so far. I feel like that picture quality is 4K.
Oh, yeah.
They just show the inbound right there. Oh, my gosh.
Crispy.
I feel like I'm on the court.
I'm glad I'm not. I wouldn't be able to keep up.
I can feel
not
you
at
on
this
that
pace.
One. With Thanksgiving and Christmas dinners weighing on me at the moment. Oh, yeah. It's, you know.
No thanks. Stoppage of action here.
See, the Greenville coach really wanted this all along because now everybody can catch their breath. You know, his master plan, it's you know, we're leaning into it right now.
Dorothy is shooting a technical free throw.
She's able to convert, giving the Red Devils their 20th point. I mean.
Is that an illegal substitution or something?
I'm wondering because I'm not actually sure what it was over.
And it was only one shot, and we got to pick any shooter off of our bench.
Our bench?
Yeah, because Dorothy was on the bench for that before they brought him back on for it, I thought.
Yeah, and I believe now he's back on the bench.
Trouble with not sitting by the scores table is we don't get this explanation. 20-14 is our score.
Have we possibly seen the return of our problems with time?
Yes. Could be that.
It's been a while.
Ellison, McKinty, able to find Brown. Thought about a three. Drives instead. Finds Ellison underneath. Tough shot. No good. Scrap for it. Dia kicks out. This is Johnson. Johnson in transition. Three-pointer fired. No good. Rebounded by Gonzalez. And off of the hands of Greenville.
Great quick thinking there to throw it off them as he himself was sailing out of bounds.
Persich coming onto the floor for Ellison. Ellison already with 7 tonight.
Good to see him thriving in this chaotic environment that Greenville is trying to, I guess, you know, put on.
A lot of quick passing. There's Brown. Looking to avoid the trap, able to do so. Bounce pass, McKinty underneath. Quadruple team, Persich, Gonzalez. Dribbles off of his own face, ends up as a pass. McKinty through contact, Unbelievable finish right there.
Yeah, tough bucket, able to force that one through.
Got to have some real mustard on that one. Three-pointer up this time. No good. Offensive rebound underneath. That one's missed. McKinty rebounds. It's with Persich. Only two ball handlers and three defenders in the backcourt. All the way up the floor. Here's Gonzalez. It'll be a two-on-one. Gonzalez stops in the lane. Gets blocked, or fouled, rather, which I enjoy way more.
Yes. Red Devils now with a chance to put their lead at double digits. It seems like slowly but surely they've kind of really been able to adjust and finally get a little bit of breathing room from this Greenville team. And I mean that figuratively and literally. They need to breathe.
Gonzalez's first points of the night. Line one back on for Greenville. 10:25 remaining in the first half, 23-14 our score. 2 for 2 on that trip. Cross court, Alvarez three-pointer up, no good. And Gonzalez, a nice one-handed rebound. Carter to Persich. McKinty calling for it, nice move, knocked out of his hands, but Alvarez with it.
It seems like the way they play defense, every once in a while, you're going to get like one of those anime steals where they're still going one direction and the ball's just not there. That's happened like three different times.
Able to break the press for the moment. Persich trying to stay away from the trap. Here's Brown through contact. Over to him. No good. Alvarez rebounds. I predict a quick fire three.
Yes.
Almost correct.
No, I think you still got it.
And he got it. Jared Johnson with a three. Second one in as many possessions.
And just like that, we got a wait.
Brown all the way to the basket.
It's a 10-point, well, no, 6-point game now?
Yeah, yep.
I think that was a two and a three. Was it two threes?
Two threes, I think.
Oh, okay.
Tip pass by Brown. Carter now pushing. Tip pass there by Johnson, and Carter gets called for a foul.
That was nearly an unintentional-looking headlock.
Kick ball instead. Apologies.
Oh, kick ball, okay.
Much better. We keep the ball, too. Maybe it was on Carter they called it on? No, okay, it was a kickball, that's right. Group two on for Greenville. Thomas, Paquette, Craig, Smitley, and Dickey. Here's McKinty, his shot is blocked. Thomas now going to push the break. Out quickly, it's Smitley. Craig with it now, crossing over to the corner. Dickey checking his footing, deep two. Fight for the rebound. Dorothy has it. Here's Gonzalez. No look pass. That was something else.
Yes, cross court at that.
Shifty there. Persich. McKinty to Gonzalez. A lot of great passing going on. Able to find Dorothy. I don't think the ball touched the ground on that possession.
Hey, that's how you wear out a team that loves to be as active as they do. Make them run around even more. And they got a good look off it in the timeout here.
8:46 remaining in the first half. 28-20 our score. Eureka leading.
Whew.
Finally get to catch our breath.
Yes. Jeez, that was I swear we've run a marathon.
Yeah. Eureka's not attempted a three-pointer yet tonight. All free throws or, you know, two-point attempts.
I can see how that's kind of come with the play style. I can see it.
22 points in the paint for Eureka. It's only six outside of that. And four of them came from the free throw line. Scoring-wise, Charlie McKinty, 8 points. Austin Ellis and Logan Dorothy both with 7. Followed by Pee Wee Brown with 4. On the other side, Jared Johnson has 8. Donato Pekak and Travis Dickey both with a 3.
Both teams, like you said, are still probably taking every single second of this timeout to catch their breath.
Yeah, you can practice for this all you want as Greenville, but I don't. I would not want to be in a conditioning practice with them.
Yeah, it's. They probably need the entire rosters of every other sports team to swap out just to keep up with them for a full practice.
Get play restarted. Smitley bringing it up for Greenville. Thomas now trying to get things started. He's trapped on the baseline. Good defense now by the Red Devils. Pekak, jump hook, no good. Scrap for it. He's still got it. Misses that. Another chance for himself. And then he's fouled. Two free throws for Greenville upcoming.
All this effort yielding free throws here. Chance to cut it to six. I'm also happy to see the Red Devils defense still holding up here. They've stuck closely to their New Year's resolution to not let this team score 100. By the way, that doesn't exist. But the way they're playing, you'd think it does.
Cody Bear checking back in. First minutes for him in a while. Great minutes from Andrew Gonzalez. Gets a good ovation coming off the floor. And two for two on that trip for Pekak.
Back to a two-possession game. The Red Devils want to see if they can stretch this one out a little more with 8:30 left in this half. 8:20 now.
McKinty finds Ellison. Ellison able to find Dorothy. Dorothy readjusting, just misses. Tipped out Thomas on the break. Good transition defense, but Thomas able to find some space. Bear high-pointing that one. Ellison, great find. Persich on the other side over the back pass.
Makes you think of that Magic Johnson clip. That's a beautiful dime right there from Persich.
Thomas way off. Smitley and off of the foot of McKinty. Group one back on the floor for Greenville.
Makes me think of, like, you know how World Cup had pools of teams from different countries? It's like three different pools that they're putting in every few minutes.
Oh, and they changed someone, too. Let's see.
That can be very confusing.
Caden Johnson onto the floor instead of Brock Bailey in group one. Oh, no, wait. Brock Bailey's there. Excuse me. Johnson with it. Deep three up, no good. Bear rebounds. Trenton Lee is not on the court. He normally is. Brown with a nice move. Good find. Dorothy, nice finish. Dorothy been on the receiving end of some really great assists the past couple possessions.
Yeah, very quick and decisive on that play. Able to get them a very fast bucket, not letting that defense apply pressure.
Bear looked like he got fouled on that. Still has it. And then ripped away. Blocked by Bear. Flings it up the court to Ellison. Three on two. Ellison dump off pass and poked away by Alvarez.
You can see the Red Devils are starting to be a little more privy to what this Greenville team wants to do on defense, the way they're pressuring and everything.
7:08 left in the first half. 32-22 our score. Ellison inbound. Bear has it. Looking to try to get his first points of the game up. A lot of contact. Still fighting for it. And a foul on Bear. I don't know if it was away from the ball, because it definitely wasn't on the ball when it happened.
Definitely would have thought that would just have been a play on, but I guess not. Another foul for the Red Devils.
Bear still unable to crack the scoring column. He has six rebounds. This is Bailey trying to get by Dorothy. Unable to do so. Good rebound from Brown. Quick outlet now. Ellison beating everyone to the basket. Great find there from Brown. Alvarez with it. Bailey to Alvarez. Open look from three. Knocked in.
Cutting the lead back to single digits briefly. Greenville now privy to the fact that the Red Devils want to get out ahead of their defense to get easy layups.
Persich trapped near half court, able to find Gonzalez. Three on two, little break. And Dorothy through contact, nice finish. Give him 13 already in the first half.
Yeah, he's been able to thrive so far the way they're playing. And those last few dishes, he's come with some nice finishes.
Bailey tries a jump shot, knocked in. I believe that's a second kind of shot from the same spot.
Yeah, he's been able to get those ones to drop here, kind of.
up-tempo game so far. Persich able to beat his man. Here's Gonzalez. Jump stop. Finds Persich once again. Kicks to the three-point line. First attempted three of the night. Brown, no good.
You see two of them with his hands on his knees. Even he is exhausted from this play style, and he's used to it. And coach right on time with substitutions.
Group two onto the court. Thomas Paquette, Craig Smitley, and Dickey. Shot up from Thomas, no good. Craig fighting for it. Offensive rebound, puts up a shot, no good. Dorothy fighting for it, rebounded by him. Trying to get some room. Able to find Ellison. Ellison with a nice quick turn. Able to find Gonzalez, who's cutting, wrap around and fouled.
Red Devils here. Gonzalez specifically at the line with a at the line with a chance. Where's work now to put his team back up 10 plus here.
Greenville's bench operates just like a hockey bench does. They've got their next line sitting next to each other. They get up, the next guys move down, and then when those guys come off the court, they just sit down at the end of it and repeat.
It truly is probably the most unique thing I have ever seen, like on a basketball court. Not even exaggeration.
...37-27. Red Devil lead. Dickey three. No good. Rebounded by Brown. Quick outlet. Ellison's there. Finds Dorothy. Dorothy now. Blocking foul. Basket's good. Logan Dorothy having himself a game.
Great to see the floodgates starting to open up here for Eureka. Seems like they're starting to get a bucket or a very, very good look every single time down the floor these last few minutes. It's good to know that they've adjusted well here in the first half. Still another half that they got to play, but it seems like they're comfortable now.
Logan Dorothy, 16 points and 5 rebounds in this first half. Already surpassing his season average. Deep three up from Thomas. Still looking for that three-pointer to go down. And they're going to say it was off of Brown.
Greenville at this point probably just trying to see if they can stay attached.
Cack was trying to check his foot. Blocking foul on Brown. Tough call there.
I feel like it's because they kind of like slightly hit each other. If it would have been full on contact, almost certainly would have been a charge on Paquette.
Group one back onto the court. Team fouls at 7 on Greenville and 5 on Eureka. So 1-1 free throws, any foul after Greenville. ...4:46 remaining in this first half. Reminder, we've got our athletic director, Sarah Shaw, joining us. Talk about her experience so far here at Eureka. Really excited to have her on, so stay tuned for that. Right now, the task at hand. Tuam with a layup.
Greenville able to get a bucket there. They're definitely hoping for a stop to see if they can cut this back to single digits.
Brown. Alvarez guarding him way out, as is customary for this Greenville defense. Persich, open look, three-pointer up from him. No good. Gonzalez, offensive rebound. Brown, Ellison. Back to Persich. Here's Dorothy down low. Kicks out. Brown, traveled.
Something that can happen so swiftly, but it's so easy to do absentmindedly. You see a traveler right there from Brown.
Post entry, here's Bailey. Tries to find Lee. It ends up in the hands of Tuam. And 4 straight points for Gawar Tuam.
Yeah, back-to-back buckets. He's getting himself in a small rhythm down there.
Not something we want to see.
Yes, definitely not. And the lead shaved back to 9, back in single digits.
Dorothy cannot be stopped. 42-31. 18 points now for Logan Dorothy. To him now, knocked out of his hands, and Dorothy goes down after the foul.
To the free throw line we go, I believe.
Yes. Yep.
Yes.
McKinty onto the court for Persich. Dia, Thomas, Pekak, Craig, and Dickey onto the court for Greenville. Logan Dorothy missing the front end of the one and one. Rare miss.
Yeah,
on the free throw line.
This team a very good free throw shooting team. Very rare miss on that one. And now Greenville with another chance to cut it back to single digits.
Craig able to find Pekak, who pauses for a moment, blows the layup. Dorothy able to get it out to McKinty, who runs the break. Here's Brown. Brown through contact finishes.
Definitely looks like that one should have been an and one.
Got a couple of plays like that from Brown. Thomas's floater, no good. McKinty not able to bring it in, but it's knocked out of bounds by Greenville. Brown with it now, 3-on-2 break. Ellison with it. Ellison off the glass and in.
Lead up to 15 now. The Red Devils seem extremely comfortable playing against this Greenville team at this point.
Dia able to get it into Pekak. Craig fighting for it. Ends up in the hands of Dickey. Here's Dia. Thomas is holding Dickey. It's probably the longest that Greenville's had it. Thomas able to get some space and knocks in a floater.
They want their coach to think that they have no avenue to score, but they're really just secretly trying to catch their breath. We all know.
Brown now lobs up. Dorothy blocked. Great defensive play. Brown trying to Harlem Globetrotter on that dribble slide.
That was almost completely mentally prepared for a DeAndre Jordan, Brandon Knight moment. Props right there for being able to get that block.
A little chirping going on between Thomas and Brown. Good defense on this possession so far. Thomas, three-pointer up. No good. Rebounded by McKinty. Here's Ellison. Quick move there, splitting the defense. Brown, easy layup. Ellison almost picks the pocket of Thomas. Thomas racing it up now. Kicks to the corner. Dickey now, three-pointer up. Yes.
That's one of the cleanest looks they've gotten in a while. And like you said, a little more testiness there from Gonzalez. As Thomas seem to kind of bump chest right there on the inbounds, and now a steal here for Greenville.
48-36. Couple ticks over a minute left in the first half. Turnaround jumper from Craig is good.
And now five straight here to cut this lead back to 10.
McKinty Gonzalez, nice spin to get some separation. No look pass. Ellison, great find. Euro step.
Whenever they get numbers, which they've done with a little more regularity, they're starting to get easy baskets.
Good move, but a flung jump shot. Brown able to finish around Thomas. Brown's going to let Thomas know about it. Dickey now, floater from him, no good. Pekak and McKinty diving for it. See who they call the foul on. Looks like they're going to call it on McKinty.
This game is so chaotic. There's always something happening because neither team, or more specifically Greenville, but, you know, Eureka does it as they try and take advantage of the defense. But even Greenville, they do not really run any sets. They just come down trying to score, and then there's usually like five bodies in the lane wrestling over the ball.
Ellison able to get a breather now. He's really been running that deep outlet route for the majority of the game.
Yeah, he finally able to take a breath and kind of you know, regain his bearings here on the bench and heading into halftime with only 26.7 left.
Cax first is good.
Funny little moment there from Brown and Pacak. Two former teammates, as you mentioned, in Lincoln.
Two for two on that trip as well. Two him on for Pacak. Briggs now getting his first minutes tonight. Gonzalez actually given some space to dribble for the first time in a while. Try to trap Brown. Gonzalez has it. Shovel pass picked off.
Now this is
Johnson.
Yeah.
But the corner now couldn't be brought in out of bounds. The Eureka basketball, 9 seconds left. Opportunity to extend their lead going into halftime. Able to find Briggs cutting up the floor. 3-on-2 break. Briggs to the corner. McKinty, three-pointer up. Contested, no good. And the clock will expire. 52-40 is going to be our score. As the half expires, Joshua.
Very energetic, very lively first half here. It's been entertaining. I'm happy this is the first men's game of 2023. I've had fun. And they're winning, so it's even more fun.
Logan Dorothy, 18.6 boards so far tonight. Again, don't go anywhere. We've got an interview coming up with Sarah Shaw, the athletic director here at Eureka College, coming up in just a little bit. But right now, Josh, let's talk a little bit more about that half action, because it's just something else to watch.
It's something else indeed. There's no other way to describe it than something else, because I truly have never seen a defensive and offensive style like theirs. And it's good seeing that, you know, Eureka, well, maybe thrown off for a few minutes, has really adjusted well. And now it seems like, you know, they're scoring a lot easier. They're getting out ahead. They know what they want to do to take advantage of the way this defense kind of tries to pile on whoever has the ball. So, you know, it's good to see that they've adjusted and that they've put themselves in a good spot for the second half.
Austin Ellison with 13 points as well and 3 assists. Pee Wee Brown, 3 rebounds, 3 assists, 10 points. And that is all we have in terms of this first action. But again, don't go anywhere. We've got our athletic director, Sarah Shaw, joining us in just a moment. We will see you in a couple of minutes.
Hopeless.
I know it was a joke, but it still hurt me.
Because of you, I feel wanted and not alone in this world.
Because you said hi to me on the first day of school, I felt included and I knew that I was going to be okay.
Hey, look, it's those guys.
Are you good to drive?
I'm fine.
How many did you have?
I should be fine.
You should be?
Go ahead and step out of the vehicle for me.
See ya, buddy. Good luck.
So turns out, buzz driving and drunk driving, they're the same thing. And it costs around $10,000. So not worth it.
And as promised, we are back with our athletic director, Sarah Shaw. Sarah, welcome, first of all. Excited to have you here at Eureka.
Well, thank you very much. I'm excited to be here.
So take me through this. You came from Maine. You did some athletic directing. You've done some coaching. Tell me about your experience over there.
Yeah, so I was a softball coach at the Division III level as well as the Division I level. I was an assistant at the Division I level, a head coach at the Division III level. I loved the administrative aspect because I felt like I could work with a lot of different students and have more of an impact. So that's the route that I decided to take. And now I'm here.
So take me through this. How did you go from, so you have a master's in sports management. How did you go from deciding that was your degree you wanted to getting to an athletic directing job?
To be honest, it was a long journey for me. It took me a while to figure out really where my niche was. Was it coaching? Was it administration? But ultimately, I always kept coming back to the student-athlete experience, and I felt like I had a bigger impact being a director of athletics versus coaching one particular sport. So I kind of went down a couple of different paths through education and coaching, and then finally landed in administration.
So would you say that this is the... Let's see. What drew you to Eureka College? Like, what was the appeal of coming to Central Illinois, especially coming from a place like Maine?
Yeah, I think it's something completely different for me. I've been in Maine and New England my entire life, and so it was time to do something new, spread my wings a little bit. I loved the rich tradition. That's something that really, as soon as I stepped foot on campus and I took the tour, I just knew this is where I needed to be. Like I said, the rich tradition, the history here, the people here, the new experience, the potential here. I really believe in President Wright's view and goals for the college, and I just felt like I could really believe in our potential.
What are some of the goals that you have for the athletic department going forward?
Obviously, at the forefront is the student-athlete experience. I think you want to make sure that students feel like these last 4 years of their, potentially last 4 years of their playing experience is the best they've ever had, and they get a great education. So I think for me, you know, some of the goals I have is enhancing that student experience, creating culture and traditions, obviously competitiveness of programs, let's win some championships, you know, so it's all of those things. But again, it all always comes back to, you know, rich traditions and student athlete experience.
What are some of the things that you're looking forward to the most experiencing here at Eureka?
Man, everything. I think, you know, everything's been so new to me. I went through my first tornado warning the other day, so that was crazy for me. So I think just everything new. I'm like a sponge right now. I'm looking forward to working with the coaches. They're teaching me a lot about our school, our conference. But yeah, I'm just soaking it all up, I guess.
So far, since you've been on campus, like, have you adjusted well? Has everything been going well? You settled in nicely?
Yeah, I think I've settled in pretty well. I think what's helped with that is the people here. The people here are one of a kind, and that is something that I can truly say with sincerity is everyone has just made me feel very at home here. So it was very, very easy to settle in here with just like kind people. The students are great. The community members are great. Faculty and staff, it's a unique place.
That's good to hear. I myself love like the tight-knit community feel, mm-hmm. So I know what you're talking about. Eureka definitely has that. It helps you settle in when you're from somewhere else. You know, we came from Lincoln College, so it helped us settle in nicely. A lot of people made a lot of friends. A lot of people are very nice here, so it's good to hear that everything's going well.
Yeah, no, I think, like Ace said, even when I was in the interviewing process, it was like, wow, these people are just different, you know, mm-hmm. And I think that helps our students as well.
So give me the most fun fact about yourself, whether that's your playing career, your administrative career. What would you say if there was one thing that you could kind of highlight, or if you want to do like a little highlight reel, top three, what are some of your favorite things you've done?
Oh, man. I think as a softball coach, making it to a national tournament, being top 10 in the country, that was something that, you know, was a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Playing in a stadium atmosphere for softball was incredible. I think that's probably my number one, but I think the biggest thing for me, it has always been seeing these athletes come in as freshmen and being wide-eyed and, you know, new to everything, and then watching them graduate. I love that transformation from freshman year to senior year, and so for me, one of the highlights is getting to see that over and over and over again. I love that.
We're really looking forward to seeing what you're going to do here at Eureka. Obviously, you're fitting in extremely well, and we're so excited to have you.
Awesome. Thank you so much for having me. I appreciate it.
Hey, thank you for being on.
That's all we have for you on the halftime show. On the other side, we've got second half action coming at you. Stick around. You're watching Eureka College Basketball on ECTV.
Yeah. If you love them enough to suck the snot out of their nose at 4 a.m., then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
Home fire drills give your family a plan of action. In a home fire, you may have less than 2 minutes to get out. So when you drill, show everyone two ways out of the house, pick a safe meeting spot, and get there in under 2 minutes. Then practice home fire drills at least twice a year. You can even make them fun. So everyone knows the sound and exactly what to do when they hear a smoke alarm. Go to ready.gov/firedrill and learn how to prepare your family for home fires.
Those socks are school colors. Are those your wrestling socks?
Yeah,
I thought our full body would be in the media. Practice down there, it's colder.
No, we like purple bats.
Yeah, that bat sucks.
Why? It's the same. It's the same.
Oh, this is my song too.
Is it?
No.
Creasy's not here yet. Is Creasy sleeping again? Whoa. Yeah, I'm sorry. All right, bring it in. Good job. All right, hey, listen up. Today's the day, cook. Oh, yeah. Roll straight to your feet. Straight to the feet. Everybody watch cook. See if you can do it. Still can't do it.
I'm a very noisy wrestler. They're gonna hear all my grunts every time I shoot.
Watch the wall.
I see it. Don't worry.
2022. I'm Devils.
Brayden won. Bobby won. Bobby beat you. You weren't even racing anybody. Hunter won. Berta won. Who's gonna win? Creasy won.
By the way, if somebody says that Beal beat me in a bench off, that was not on record. It's never been recorded, and it never happened. So just have to throw that out there.
Son of a biscuit.
Oh, ho, ho.
Clock saves a lot.
Please don't actually throw me.
I'm not.
You stabbed me
like that. With the mic. Did I mention Hunter was big? Because he is.
He said, why not find someone new? Oh, God. Did you guys do the sideways ones? The sideways ones.
Okay, that's a little bit too aggressive.
Get his shoulder down. Dude. Wait, there we go. It's good. Nice and good.
I gotta be honest.
What?
No, I've got all of them.
They're hot.
Got a bunch of starfishes around here. Starfish. This is a good Taylor.
There's like a 90% chance that Drew's gonna break this because he hurts me every practice.
Okay, wait. That's not true. It is actually kind of
true. It is a little true. Oh my God.
It's not fun. But I got one more left. Let's go.
I gotta get filmed going bottom.
Bad time.
Wow, okay.
just hit Drew in the face. Yeah. I gotta get my first blood in.
What's this guy doing here? Put your back on the mat. There you go. Feel a difference? Get this down. Oh, a little back popper there.
Ah. Oh, you would have had me instead of.
I thought you were in down block.
Oh, I was. You have been sprawling your freaking head.
You're right. Oh, where are you sprawling now?
That's awesome.
Welcome back to Eureka, Illinois, where the Red Devils lead 52-40 as they prepare to come out of halftime. Clock just about winding down. Spencer Davis and Joshua Howard with you as always. Joshua, turnover battle, it looks a little funky because it's 11 for the Red Devils and 8 for Greenville, but honestly, it seems like it could be a lot worse.
It definitely seems like it could be a lot worse, and I'm honestly a bit surprised. I mean, I guess I'm not surprised the numbers are close, but I'm slightly surprised we're ahead either way, though. It doesn't seem like it's hurt us too much. You know, we're up 12. They definitely were adjusting very, very well, a lot more towards the latter half of that first half. And, you know, they had their lead as big as 15, down to 12. It's not really too much shaved off, but they just got to make sure they play another 20 minutes.
Be group one, the starters back on the floor. And Ellison with the fake out.
I'm not even going to lie. I myself forgot that we switched. That's how basketball works, ladies and gentlemen. But I briefly did forget myself.
Shout out to the rest of the team for selling that so well. You know, like, that's great acting. Give them all an Oscar.
Honestly, yeah, that's a beautiful out of the – I mean, it wouldn't be timeout. It would be out of halftime play right there just to get it easy, too.
Great find from Ellison. Having himself a great half to start. Dorothy up to 20 now.
They seem, like we said, they seem so much more comfortable playing against this defense now.
Hickory dickory, we've had some trickery. Ball goes out of bounds, 56-42. Second half starting like a Jimi Hendrix solo, to say the least.
And now the Red Devils with a chance to make this their biggest lead of the game if they're able to score.
Bears got to get it in, able to do so. Persich able to find McKinty cross court, and he lost it. It's going to be off of him. .1909, just got the second half started. Bailey now, the elbow jumper, no good. McKinty with a nice rebound. Did not want to be helped up after that.
You know, these teams were a little chippy towards the end of that first half. It definitely has transferred over. Although, thankfully, it hasn't manifested into anything.
Yeah, and McKinty, early on in the season against SIUE at that exhibition, came down awkwardly on that shoulder. So I'm sure, you know, as a prior injury, you're still trying to work off of. Going down in an awkward position like that, you're not too happy when you get back up.
Yeah, it's a mental battle as well as a physical one. And, you know, obviously, He's trusting his body and trying to just completely regain comfort with that shoulder.
Dorothy a little cherry picking. Great find from Persich. It's a good day to be a guard. You know, you're really boosting those assist numbers.
It is, and now the Red Devils their largest lead of the game here at 16.
Underneath, Pekak unable to finish. Offensive rebound for himself. Blocked from behind by McKinty. Able to find Thomas. Just knocks it in. First three of the night. Cross court, McKinty, Ellison, able to turn it around, gets Craig sliding, and Ellison will take it all the way himself.
And it seems like no matter how many layups the Red Devils get, Greenville is not really adjusting all that much, just continuing to kind of let it happen.
That's just their play style. Like, they live and die by it.
Truly.
15-point lead for Eureka. Second half started with a 12-point lead for Eureka, so they've extended it slightly in these first couple of minutes. Dickey from three. No good. Rebounded by Pekak. Good hands from Dorothy. Bounces back out. Thomas run off the line. Rises up, blocked by Bear. Rebounded by Dorothy.
Yeah, great anticipation right there by Bear, able to pin that one.
Lobs up. Bear able to finish.
He decided to take it easy on their mental states and not dunk it on that one.
Don't count him out, though. Might get vengeful and put one down later. Bears' first points of the night.
As the Migos would say, yeah, that way. We are the Red Devils with a chance to once again see if they can make their largest lead of the game. They've extended it already.
62-45 our score. And Ellison.
It was almost too easy right there. And, you know, you see them kind of fumbling it for once.
If you see that sometimes in football. Guys will start, you know, they think they got it. They'll start looking up at the rim, and you just didn't quite have the ball.
Yeah, you got to always, coaches always say, make sure you've caught it first before you try and do anything.
Sometimes you just need a little reminder. Unfortunately, it's usually at the bad times.
Yeah, even the most disciplined players can still make that mistake sometimes.
Bear blocks it off of the Cac's head.
Yes, that is why I was laughing.
A complete erasure. Smitley now finds Dickey. Dickey, another three-pointer up. No good. McKinty gets called for a foul.
You know, I had to clarify that right there. I can't just be unprofessional there. That was hilarious.
It's rare to see a ball go directly straight down on a block, but Bear, I think, got on top of that shot.
Yes. But guy didn't even really, like, respond. Like, he didn't, like, jolt or kind of flinch or anything. He just got hit in the head and kept playing like nothing happened.
Ball go bonk. 16:56 left in the second half. Eureka up 15. Logan Dorothy with 22 points and 7 rebounds thus far. Austin Ellison following with 17 points and 5 assists. A little discussion between the officials and players, perhaps. Bailey able to seal off Persich. And a travel. Thought he took a couple of extra steps.
I definitely thought I saw that one as well.
Bear's going to check in for McKinty. McKinty with going to the bench. 8 points, 5 rebounds, and 2 assists. Likely see him again, I would imagine. A lot of ball game left. Brown to Persich. Loses the handle on it. They're going to say it was tipped. Here's Ellison. Ellison lobs up. Brown. And a foul. From Tuam. Scary collision. Glad to see both guys okay.
Yeah, great to see the good sportsmanship on that one as well. Tuam helping Brown up after nearly getting posterized. But, you know, he didn't.
Whew, that would have been something.
Your 6'2 guard absolutely, you know.
Eviscerating your big. Yeah, that would be. Your 6'8 center. Yeah, I'd be sad.
Height-wise, that is literally the equivalent of, like, Kyrie Irving dunking on LeBron straight up. That's wild.
Yeah. Two for two on that trip from Pre-Wee Brown. 12 points for him tonight.
Yeah, he's been one of the main contributors in helping the Red Devils really settle into this defense they're playing against as well. Him and Ellison, like you said, a great day to be a guard. Persich has gotten free as well. All of them very much helpful in the fact that the Red Devils have a 17-point lead right now.
The Bear with it now. Ellison able to find Brown, who's cutting all the way to the basket, and it's blocked by Tuam. Nice recovery. Red Devils shooting 65% tonight. They've only attempted 3 three-pointers.
Hey, when they have to be an inside team, they're showing that they can... They can very much thrive in that position.
Just going to go all the way to the safety valve with Persich. Track it down. Able to find Brown. Ellison. Lobs up. Bear! Oh, my goodness!
You said it. You definitely said it. He was the candidate, and he did it. That was beautiful.
An offensive foul going the other way.
I have no words. And with perfect timing, we are taking a timeout.
66-47 is our score. Wow.
That was amazing.
I don't know if we can get a replay on that one, but wow. Cody Bear with the exclamation point on that lob. Unbelievable.
It was so powerful, too. Like, it. Don't you dare try and block this, or else you will end up in the ground.
Two-handed slam. Cody Bear. Wow, I don't even know where to go from there.
SC Top 10, we got to get it on there.
We got to try at least. My goodness. With authority. 66-47 our score with the Red Devils leading. Good time to be a Red Devil fan. SLIAC Conference opener going on right now.
And now both teams back on the court. The collective breaths probably finally retained from that amazing lob, as well as regained from this play style that has both teams running up and down the court like maniacs.
I mean, Persich with it. Struggling to find anyone. Bear, it's knocked out of his hands by Johnson.
And the Red Devils this time down a chance to see if their lead can surpass the 20-point mark. And still, I'm extremely impressed and prideful of our defense, the fact that this team hasn't even cracked 50 yet, 4 minutes into the second half, with the amount of points they average on a nightly basis.
Yeah, the Red Devil defense has done a really good job of getting back in transition, because a lot of times Greenville will still put up about 100 points. They may lose, but they're putting up about 100, and right now they're nowhere close to that pace.
Yeah,
I shouldn't
probably
say nowhere close, but.
I get what you're saying, though.
And a 10-second violation.
Great defense on that possession by Greenville. They get the ball back. If I was them, I'd probably be taking pride in making sure we're never at any point down 20. So, that, you know, that's probably what they're fighting for.
To him with it now. Euro step, nice finish there from him.
Yeah, he's had a few nice finishes around the bucket here tonight.
Gonzalez with it. Sidearm pass there. Persich, Ellison. Back to Persich. Gonzalez finding Dorothy. Looks to dribble, kicks in the corner. Gonzalez working it around. Ellison now relocating. Alvarez harassing him. Trapped now, top of the key. Nice find. Brown pauses for a second and finishes.
Faked them both up. That was great use of the fundamentals right there to get an easy layup.
Ball loose for a moment. Able to find Bailey, and two of them was not cutting yet. Group two onto the floor for Greenville. Brown, Persich, shovel pass, Dorothy with it, nice finish. Give him 24 tonight.
And ever since the first half, it seemed that whoever is in that right dunker spot is really just getting, or left, really, either side, is just getting a great look as we see a tough three banked in from deep there.
Salas able to find Persich and lost the handle on it.
The Red Devils lead briefly reaching 21 before being cut to 18. Now Greenville back with the ball, a chance to put it at 16 or 15.
Thomas now inbounding cross court with Smitley. Dickey, 17 on the shot clock, floater over Dorothy, no good, rebounded by Persich. Tried to quick outlet again, saved, but it's with Brown. Brown all the way up the floor, mossed, behind the back pass, pause, finish.
The fundamentals are killing it tonight. They have so many highlight plays just because they're being patient and, you know, using ball fakes, still using all the things you're taught as a little kid.
And Ellison on the left side. Putting the beat down now. Gas pedal to the floor.
Every bucket basically makes it their largest lead of the night, 22 now.
Craig through contact, no good, rebounded by Gonzalez. Ellison with it. Able to find Brown, who finishes. Austin Ellison, 19 points, 9 assists now. Brown with 16 points, that is, to clarify. 76-52, 13:40 to go. Smitley run off the line, Pekak. Able to find Dickey, and it's erased by Dorothy.
It seems like absolutely nothing is slipping through the cracks at this point. They're playing great.
Oh, Brown almost threw down the lob.
For a second, I thought it was going to be in.
13-19, 78-52 the score. Smitley left short. Dorothy kind of just tosses it up to Gonzalez. Nice move from Brown to get some separation. Euro step ball, fake, no good. Cat rebound. No good. Persich able to get a rebound.
Steph Curry does not have the pot on that one.
Shovel pass. Here's Dorothy. No good. Offensive rebound for himself. It's okay. Just getting those stats up.
I understand it completely. The Red Devils' largest lead of the night, 28 points here. And even they need a breather.
80-52 is our score. .12:45 remaining here. Logan Dorothy, 28 points tonight, 9 boards. He's just trying to get close to that double-double. Austin Ellison, 19 points, 10 assists. Pee-wee Brown, 18 points. This is, it's fun.
It's great team basketball. It's what you want to see from this Eureka Red Devils team, and they're completely taking care of business. This team 1-7. Obviously, there's always that small little, you know, that can be misleading, but they have completely taken care of business in this one, up 28. And with 12:45 left to go, it's just great to see if they can continue to execute and build those winning habits.
28-point lead for Eureka. It's a good day to be a Red Devil.
It is. It is. It's a great day to, you know, breathe in that first win of 2023.
Yeah, we talked about wanting to avenge the women's loss earlier. I would say this is as good as it gets.
Yeah, definitely as good as it gets. Just seeing your team come out here and do what they're supposed to do, and you see smiles on the face of Brown as he goes back on the court. They're having fun doing it, and that's always what you want to see above, well, not above everything else, but, well, yeah, kind of. You know, you want to see everybody happy above everything else.
Lee now over to Bailey. Alvarez trying a three-pointer. That one rattles out. Carter fighting for a rebound. It's Johnson with it, though. Shot no good. Carter does bring that one in.
Those comically slippery rebounds is what that possession just made me think of.
Lee harassing Carter. Carter able to keep going all the way to basket. Little weight room.
The big 3-0. Red Devils' lead has reached 30.
To him now. Knocks one in. Man, this is a game where you wish everyone was still at school.
You do.
Dorothy, no good.
Got to play these highlights back, you know, when everyone gets back here in 11 days.
A little bit of a run here, and a little too high on that pass. Cody Bear on for Logan Dorothy.
That pass might have been an assassination attempt. Thankfully, there was no one in the seat.
.82:56 the score. Johnson with it. Over to Bailey. Jump shot. No good. Fought for. Ends up back in the hands of the shooter, Johnson.
Very, very quietly, if a bucket is scored here, we would have 6-7 straight points here by Greenville responding after going down 30.
Alvarez inbounding to Johnson, hoists up a three. I don't know if they didn't realize the shot clock was not expiring or what, but quick fire three is fine with me. Carter on the break finds McKinty. McKinty couldn't quite reel it in, able to find Bear. Bear spinning and jump hook, no good. Corner three up from Alvarez, no good. And the putback from Bailey's good.
A truly do wonder how this team's home crowd, like, are they used to this, just their heads snapping back and forth like it's a ping pong game for 40 minutes, or is, like, are even they a little surprised every time that, you know, they got to have hydration to make sure they have enough energy to keep up with the game for an hour and a half.
McKinty heads to the bench. Lane violation. .11:06 remaining in this second half. Gonzalez a little pump fake. Brown spinning, trying to evade the trap. Eventually is trapped, tie up. Possession arrow belonging to Greenville.
Brown saying he called a timeout. The refs did not see the signal or did not hear him, so it's not going to matter. Six straight points here by Greenville. A chance to make it 8, possibly 9.
Lob play, a little too tall for Johnson. Quick outlet from Brown to Ellison. Ellison just wastes his time. Oh, and misses. There's Brown, a little head fake from him, and then that's erased by Tulum.
I feel like Tulum and Brown have had like six different, you know, just interactions at the rim, whether it be dunks, dunk attempts, layups, whatever. They just, thankfully, you know, the sportsmanship's still there, though.
Ellison able to find Bear, who misses that. Should have just dunked it, I guess. That shot left short off the leg and out of bounds.
I don't know if I've ever seen someone so aggressively run into a two-dribble mid-range pull-up instead of a three-pointer. Like, that's not usually the way people play basketball, at least in the last, you know, 10 years that Steph Curry's existed.
Brown able to find Carter. Here's Bear with it now. Bear through some contact. Good finish from him. Craig no good. Rebounded by Gonzalez. Gonzalez now credited with 6 rebounds tonight. Here's Brown giving a little too much room. Decides to not shoot that. They'll run their offense a little bit. Here's Bear. Goes out. Carter thought about a 3, drives instead, threw some contact. Good finish from the freshman.
Yeah, with 3 different sets of hands swiping at him, able to keep that one and lay it in. That's a tough finish right there.
Dia now on the wing. Here's Thomas. Thomas floater over Bear, no good. Bear corralling a rebound and then fouled. Bear's got 6.7 rebounds tonight. Looking to keep that double-double streak alive. He's got enough time to do it, I think.
Yeah, he's definitely got enough time. And, you know, that's probably, you know, we may see a little bit of stat chasing. Not that there's anything wrong with that, of course, though. Just got to make sure the win is staying in the bag.
Bear, a little assist from the big man.
Besides, whoever said it's wrong to, you know, increase your accolades. If I can say I've had 5 straight double-doubles, I definitely want an opportunity to go after it.
Thomas now way out there. Dia. Thomas splitting a trap, going all the way to the basket. Erased by Bear. .88-58 our score. 9:21 remaining in the second half. Kack with it. Trying to get through. Kicks out. Thomas run off the line. Gets some separation. Mid-range Jay. No good. Rebounded by Kack. And then a foul.
I can say I was expecting that one. Red Devils score over or under 35.
Ooh,
or I guess that would be 34.5.
I don't know. It's a good question. I'll take the over. I'm feeling spicy.
I think I'm going to go with you. I'll take the over.
Over on margin of victory?
Yes,
34.5. Play along at home.
But you know how betting works. The moment you say that.
Yeah, that happens.
Yeah.
30-second timeout taken by Greenville. 88-61, our score, under 9 minutes to go. You're just tuning in. You missed out on a lot of good basketball being played tonight. Right now we're in the men's game. 28 points from Logan Dorothy leading the way for all scorers. But he plays for Eureka, so that's even cooler. 9 rebounds for him as well. Followed by Austin Ellison with 21 points and 10 assists. Pee Wee Brown contributing 18 points, 6 rebounds, and 3 assists. And then Gawar Tuam with 10 points on the other side. He's the only guy in double figures for Greenville. But Keyshawn Thomas, Jared Johnson, and Brock Bailey all with 8 as well. So a very balanced scoring attack, as you would expect when you have 1,000 players playing for
you. Yes, very much so. Definitely very balanced attack, and that's what we were expecting from them coming in. So they've kind of, you know, played exactly how we expected, and the Red Devils seem to have known what to do and how to handle this team coming in, and they find themselves up 27 here with 8:53 left.
Be Carter with it. Defense still harassing. Here's Bear. Bear finds Ellison underneath. Ellison threw a lot of contact. And they're going to call a foul on him. Ellison saying a couple things to him.
We've seen, you know, bits of chippiness throughout this game so far, occasionally, but neither team really trying to take it outside of basketball, which is always good to see.
Johnson with it, bringing it up. Split the defense, able to get a shot up, left short, ends up being a lob really for Bailey. Things are definitely getting a little chippy, a little extra contact everywhere, and going to call Alvarez on that. Maybe in an attempt to kind of just stop a lot of contact.
Yeah, probably.
Just call a really soft foul and just kind of dissuade people from making it worse.
Gives the Red Devils a chance to have a cleaner inbounds than they do.
Gonzalez, mid-range J, too strong.
See, now the conspiracy is going to start that we have the refs on our team. That was an accident.
Whoops. Johnson's three-pointer rattles out. Two of them now fouled. See who they attribute it to.
What just happened?
Alvarez doing some embellishing, it seems. The official saw the entire thing, so he was not impressed.
This game has truly been like one of the most entertaining ones I've ever seen in my life.
One could say, I'm not impressed by your performance.
I am not impressed by your... I don't even know how to say it like that. I wish I could.
8:10 remaining. Definitely some words being exchanged between everyone. It's definitely been an uptick in that, I would say, in the past couple minutes. It's been going on throughout the game. We saw Thomas and Brown kind of say a few things to each other. We saw Thomas and McKinty, I think, maybe,
yeah,
as well. But, yeah, now we're seeing Gonzalez and Alvarez having some choice words. It's Carter, Ellison. Pass tip, Bailey able to get it up. Here's Alvarez, and sometimes the ball is slippery.
Yes, it's like a bar of soap on occasion.
A greased watermelon, if you will.
Yes. That's one of the funniest descriptions of basketball I've ever heard. Yet it fits.
You ever done that?
I haven't.
It's like a water sport. You grease a watermelon, and then you try to like get the watermelon, but then it's wet and slick.
Uh-huh.
It's really hard to, you know, keep in contact with.
Huh. That actually sounds fun. We may have to do that.
And I think they float. This is a watermelon. I don't know.
That would make sense, yeah. I think that would make sense. Plus, you know, oil.
But then you have buttered watermelon, so I wouldn't recommend eating it.
Oh, so butter's the specific type of slick?
Well, no, yeah, you grease it.
Like, okay.
So you put butter on the rind.
Oh, okay.
I guess you could eat it still. Just don't eat the rind. I hope nobody's eating rinds at home. Anyway. Basketball is being played. Under 8 to go. 88-64 the score. Eureka leading. Alvarez, three-pointer up. No good. Rebounded by Ellison. fires one up. Here's Bear is fouled. First trip to the line for Cody Bear tonight. Like Josh mentioned on the pregame, a SLIAC Player of the Week in December. Came off of a couple of fantastic performances down at Washington, including a game where he had 19 points and 22 rebounds.
Yeah, and he's continued, you know, dominating the way we know he can. It's great to see that, something that did not change in the new year.
And maybe not the biggest game from him. It's only 6 points, 7 rebounds from him, but it's a game where you didn't need him to, really. You just needed him to do his thing.
Yeah, and he has. He's protected the rim pretty well, made things very difficult for the opposing team down there. And like you said, this was a game kind of tailor-made for the guards to shine, and they have done their job as well.
And also destroy any sort of hope that Greenville may have.
Yes. We always love that.
Yes. Bear, no good. Pekak rebounds. Smitley bringing it up. Eureka zone has worked wonders tonight, as it seemingly will hold Greenville underneath their scoring average for the season. Kick to the corner, three-pointer up. No good, rebounded by Pekak. He's going to try a three-pointer, no good. Kept alive by Thomas, ends up in the hands of Craig. Craig driving. Smitley, step back, three up. No good, rebounded by Bear.
I should have never created that over and under. It's just not going to happen.
No. Carter fouls. The one-on-one free throws now. Dorothy and Brown to come onto the floor before Bear and Ellison. Free throw, no good. Oh, it was a 1-1.
Surprised that was called a foul there. Looked like a clean block. But Pekak will be going to the line here.
.653 to go in the second half. Cax first is no good. It's crazy to think about the way that the second half started was with the trickery by Eureka to set up their set on the wrong side of the court, and Ellison got a free run at the basket, and it's kind of been just over since then.
It really has. They've consistently stretched out their lead since then, and they've kept this Greenville team at a comfortable distance, kind of used their over-enthusiasm on defense, should we say, against them, and tired a lot of their players out.
Thomas trying to maintain handle of it. Persich knocks it out from behind him. He's got it. Going to go up and finish himself. Always nice to reward yourself for your theft.
Yes. Great to see him take that one all the way for what has to be another layup of one of the easiest nights of his career on that end.
Keck. The layup, give him a double-double. 10 points, 10 rebounds for him tonight. Over the head toss, here's Dorothy. Dorothy threw some contact, and good, 30 points for him. Scrap for it, Pekak going all the way, a little too out of control. Carter fouled on the floor. Is the determination. It's going to be a 1-1, I believe, still.
We're still seeing groups swapped in and out. Here, I wonder if this will be the last one of the night.
Yeah, it seems like their stints and shifts have gone on a little bit longer as the game has got a little bit more out of hand.
Yeah, I'm guessing that's the reason why as well. They're not necessarily close. The coach is kind of letting the guys get a little more breather.
And no good. Rebounded by Lee. To Greenville's credit, they're still pushing the pace as much as they were in the first half.
Yeah, they are unflinching from the way they play basketball.
Gonzalez back to Carter. Tip pass ends up in the hands of Persich. Here's Brown. Brown floater, no good. Going to get a call on Brown, it seems, or no. Dorothy drew a foul in some way. I don't.
It's very confusing, that play was. Although I've probably said that about more plays in a single game tonight than I ever have before. Because a lot of times it just seems like I will blink and the ball will be with the other team.
And no good there from Dorothy. Missed a couple of openers on one and ones. Good finish there at the rack from Lee. 4 points from him tonight. Persich now able to evade the trap. Here's Brown. Brown, nice Euro step.
Lovely move there in the paint. We've seen a handful of those from him and Ellison tonight, and they finished most every time.
Three-pointer up from the corner, no good. Rebounded by Brown. Brown's got 20.7 rebounds tonight. Gonzalez able to find Dorothy underneath, and he finishes that one off. Dorothy now 32 points, 10 boards.
We've entered the final five of this game. 4:37 left, 4:34 now.
It just seems like the shifts are still going.
Both teams are just going to run until their legs don't work.
Carter now, three-pointer up from him, no good. Dorothy tips it to keep it alive. Carter pokes it loose for a moment.
I got to say, though, like you pointed out, it actually is impressive that they are playing this strictly to, you know, their play style, not changing because the game is, you know, visibly over. They're just continuing to play the way Greenville plays, and the Red Devils have to continue to pass and play with the urgency so that they're not turning the ball over every possession.
I mean, the lead was at 35 at one point. It's down to 21 now. I mean, I would still think with under 4 minutes, it's probably still out of reach, but...
Yeah, I definitely believe it's out of reach. But, yeah, like you said, they've gotten a notable amount of more defensive stops in these last handful of minutes.
Carter couldn't quite wrap that pass around. McKinty onto the floor for Carter.
The regret I would feel if the mentioning of my bet was the start of one of the worst collapses of all time. Oh, my gosh. But that is not going to be the case. Red Devils up 21 with 3:35 left.
Wet spot on the floor. They'll try to mop it up. Who do you think scores the 100th point for Eureka?
I'm going to go... that's tough. I think I'm going to go McKinty.
All right.
Watch them get subbed out, the entire team.
We'll see. Seems like they still got their foot on the gas pedal late in this one. You always like to make a statement to the rest of the conference that, hey, we're here to compete. Thomas now, three-pointer up from him. No good, touch the top of the backboard, out of bounds.
Yeah, like you said, though, a great conference win, a great way to start off conference play. Definitely sending a message, beating this team like this and holding them 30 points to this very second, at least, below their average. It's a great defense and very good execution on offense that you need.
Eric passed their turnover by the Red Devils.
Jeez, maybe my over-under should have been 20 points.
Timeout taken. 97-76 our score. Red Devils lead here at home. And we will step aside for a brief moment as the teams collect themselves on the sidelines. You're watching Eureka College Basketball on ECTV.
I've done my first time bartending, so.
It's a sausage party in here.
It's fun. I'm very familiar.
Yeah, because you're a sexy girl, Sam. Last thing,
yeah,
is that the music, when Momo kicks it into high gear, is going to get a little bit loud in here. Mm-hmm. So your customers are going to have a hard time hearing you. So you may want to
What?
To Eureka, where the home Red Devils lead by 21 late in the second half. Spencer Davis and Joshua Howard joining you per usual.
Yeah, closing out these last 3:12 here. The Red Devils will win, it seems. Just remains to be seen by how much. The lead now trimmed to 19. At one point was upwards of 30.
It's the first time it's been under 20 in quite some time.
Yeah, probably since the early minutes of this first half. The Red Devils came in, I believe, with a 12-point lead. Didn't take them too much longer to push above that. So, yeah, like you said, and now their lead down to 17.
Greenville not going away quite yet. Here's McKinty, Persich. Able to find Brown. Brown over Thomas. Two guys that kind of been chirping at each other all game.
Yeah, and Brown looking to get the better of him in this one. Seems we were wrong. The coach has one more group swap in him. I got one more in me. I got one more in me.
Three-pointer from Dickey goes down.
Down to 16, the lowest it's been since the early minutes of this second half.
Also the lowest it's been since it was 19. The Cat still hustling.
I'm kind of happy he hustled for that one because I actually was not sure who that went off of.
True. Very helpful.
I would really like the Red Devils to not let this get anywhere close to 10.
Yeah, that would be ideal.
The domination part of this would go away if this is like less than 15 points.
Agreed. Bear to Ellison. Back to Bear.
And you can see the energy that team has now. They believe in the slightest of slight chances that they could get something done. And they're all over the Red Devils with even more vigor than before.
I mean, you can kind of look at it as like the same type of way they play defense.
Yeah.
You know, there's the small hope you get a steal on it.
Yeah.
And if not, you just keep going. You go at it again.
Yeah, it's a relentlessness that, if channeled in the right way, probably could be something pretty good. But, you know, they're still looking for that way to channel it.
Noah Persich with the 100th point tonight. First time Eureka's cracked the 100 mark this season.
Well, I was wrong. But I'm happy to see we've cracked 100. The offense has looked like, you know, it's looked easy, so it's no surprise that they've reached the century mark.
Johnson now stuck in the lane, kicks out. Tough shot there, can't go. And then out of bounds. Off of a member of the Panthers. Gonzalez checking back in for Bear. Ellison to Gonzalez. McKinty. Minute and a half left in the second half.
The Red Devils playing off this last 90 seconds.
Able to find Dorothy. Dorothy blocked by Bailey. Here's Johnson now with some separation, tries a shot, and knocks one in.
That's one of the kindest bounces I've seen in a minute. They're able to get that one to go, and back to 16.
Gonzalez back to McKinty. And Ellison. He's going to try to slow things down. I don't think Greenville's going to oblige them, though.
He did kind of shave off half the shot clock, though, the way they were defending the ball.
Dorothy no good on that shot attempt. Greenville will go right back out and run. 45 seconds left. 101-85 our score. 105-88 the score after that three.
Tracy McGrady should not be in this gym. Let's hope there's nothing in the works.
Persich able to get by. Here's Ellison all the way to the basket. Give him 20. 3 points tonight and 10 assists.
Once the Red Devils get it back after this possession, they can hold until the end of the clock. And it seems like Greenville will not let them do that.
Ellison still attacking. Can't finish. Ball tipped out. Johnson. Everyone's still playing until the final buzzer. Spin move. Nice finish there from Johnson. He's got 15 now.
Well, it got close to 10, but thankfully it doesn't seem like it will be below 10.
And our final score, 103-92, and a barn burner here at Eureka. Joshua, a great team performance.
Yeah, great team performance. Holding this team nearly 15 points below their average, not really letting their offense get off at any point. We saw, you know, the little flurry at the end there, but the Red Devils defense, the score won't tell it, was amazing tonight, and their offense was probably ran as smoothly as I've ever seen it. Seemed like shots just came easy to them, especially after that first 5 to 7 minutes. For the rest of the first half and for all the second half, they really got whatever they wanted whenever they wanted.
Leading scorer tonight, Logan Dorothy, 32 points, 10 rebounds, followed by Austin Ellison with 23 points and 10 assists. Pee Wee Brown contributing 22 points, 7 rebounds, 3 assists. On the other side, Jared Johnson, 15 points, 5 rebounds, 6 assists for Greenville. And Donato Pekak, 14 points and 11 rebounds. Our next broadcast of Eureka College basketball will tentatively be on Saturday, the 7th of January, when the Eureka men's and women's team travel to Westminster. They tip off at 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock, respectively. Again, tentatively, we'll be on the radio. On behalf of our entire crew and my broadcast partner, Joshua Howard, this is Spencer Davis. Thank you for joining us. Have a great evening.